story this morning.
Our
story is going to be taken from the Bible. Before we start our story this morning, let's ask someone to pray for us. We ask Mary to come and pray for us. Before we start our story this morning. We put our hands together for prayer. Thank you.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. Thank you that you have made us to rest, for our lives to build a new time, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for giving us a Bible so that we can read about your Lord, Lord. Please, Lord, guide us and keep our minds safe as we are about to read a story about you, Lord. Please, Lord, guide us as we are about to learn about you, Lord.
Our story this morning is taken from the book of Acts chapter 10. I'm going to tell you the story this morning. Are you listening? The story is about Brother Cornelius.
As you can see down
the screen, it's about Cornelius and Peter. Brother Cornelius loved Jesus.
Cornelius,
does anyone love Jesus? Can you raise your hand if you love Jesus?
Jesus.
Very good. Also, Brother Cornelius used to pray. The story says he was not eating food for 4 days. And he was praying. And then as he was praying, you know when you're praying, you close your eyes, and you can't see anything, then suddenly Brother Cornelius saw something. Brother Cornelius saw an angel. Wow! What would you do if you saw an angel? Brother Cornelius was afraid. Then the angel said something. The angel, boys and girls, said, God has been listening to your prayers, Brother Cornelius. When you were praying, he was listening. He was listening to your prayer. This is what you are to do. You are to go to Joppa. Send some servants to go to Joppa. Two of those servants, when they get to Joppa, they should look for a man called Peter. When they find Peter, they should call him to come. So Brother Cornelius sent two servants and a soldier, as you can see in the
picture.
And they went to Peter's house. While Peter was there in the house, the Holy Spirit told Peter, some people are waiting for you. Go to the door. And then Peter goes to the door and finds this man. Then he goes with Cornelius too. And they go to Cornelius' house. Now, as you can see, they get to Cornelius' house.
When
they get to Cornelius' house, they find Cornelius there with the family. Sitting and waiting to listen to the story. To hear more about Jesus. Cornelius was happy that Peter had come to tell him more about Jesus.
Just move
to the previous slide, please. Thank you very much. And when they got to Cornelius' house, Peter began to tell them more about Jesus. And then
other
friends joined to listen to stories about Jesus. And they were glad that they would hear about Jesus. What do you learn from this story, boys and girls? We learn from this story that God is sending people to you and I When you come to Sabbath and listen to Bible stories, there are many others who want to know about Jesus. And you and I know about Jesus. And today I'm telling you that, like Peter, who went to tell the people about Jesus, you and I also have the chance to go and tell others about Jesus. Many people at school, our teachers, they want to know about Jesus. And you are there to tell them about Jesus. This week, as you begin, I want to challenge you to go and to your teachers, to your friends in class, and tell them about Jesus. Just bow our heads as we pray. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you in a special way that as little children, we are able to tell others about Jesus. We ask that, like Peter, we may go out and tell others about Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you for that wonderful children's story.